Hello, my wonderful people. A wonderful, blessed day to all of you. This is Meriblu TV, Meriblu International TV. If today is your first time of coming across my channel, if you've been watching and watching, have not made up your mind to subscribe, you know, you are just stopping by, you are just watching, you are just trying to make up your mind to subscribe, please. You know, there is nothing to wait. Just hit the red button that says subscribe and also a bell notification that will come out. Just click it. It will notify you whenever I upload a new video. And for those of you that have subscribed to this channel, those of you that are following me from beginning to this time, God bless you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Without you, I wouldn't have been here. Without you, I wouldn't have come this far. Thank you so much. God bless you for subscribing. God bless you for watching. God bless you for liking. God bless you for sharing and also invite your friends. Thank you so much. So guys, without wasting much of your time, you know, this is a video of a Zimbabwe woman who caught her husband, you know, wedding another woman. He's so heartbroken. You know, the woman came, or she got an information that, you know, told her that the husband is marrying to another woman. She came to interrupt the wedding. You know, she was from afar. She was telling the reverend father of the church to stop the wedding. You know, she was trying to figure out what was wrong, what is going on. You know, she was shouting. Even she had a baby on her back when she came. She was telling everyone that, telling the husband what is going on here, that the man, they slept this morning and woke up. The man, you know, do some, you know, normal training as usual. You know, this morning, give her kisses and all the rest. And not only that, she didn't have only one child. She had other children for this man. So the man dressed up this morning and zoom off to the house, not knowing that the man is on the altar trying to give another woman. Yes, I do. So my people, without wasting much of your time, let me leave you to watch the video. Then I'll be right back. Then we'll talk about it.
My children, can you come here? This man is my husband. We haven't divorced, we haven't separated, we never quarreled, we even slept with you. This morning he's from home. I don't know what is happening here. And my, of course, my children, these are my girls.
So my wonderful people, I know you don't watch the video, you don't see him. You know, this one Nabi say everything don't clear. Make I use broken token. I beg make una pardon me, you know. We are be saying English, no green enter. I go use broken enter there. So my people, you see what would they talk about? You know, so for those of you where they watch me for this my channel, I'd always they hit on marriage. And they talk about family too much. I not be saying my marriage is bad. No, take her like that. No, even try to go that side. My marriage good, well, you know. But you get some of our fellow women will be saying, what did they pass through for their marriage? Things where they know sometimes where they happen, they will come, you go come, they say, eh? How manage? You see this woman now. You see her? She said they have been married for years. She never filed a divorce paper to the man. The man never given divorce paper. They never quarrel. You know, quarrel where I mean, be say, quarrel where we say people go gather, police or whatever, you know, family, they will come to Georgia. None of such. All those things never happen. Although no marriage, where they know they get misunderstanding. I mean, some people, they will come and they say, ah, my marriage is A to Z, it's 100%, even 100 plus. We hear, we believe you, no wala. We don't even pray, say, may any woman marriage, make it get common. All we pray every day, where we say, may the marriage, they go well. But for me, I no pray for 100% marriage. You know what you hear? Yes, so I did not pray for 100% marriage. I pray, baby, say, sometimes, may misunderstanding there for marriage. So that, you know, there's some certain things that you have in your mind, you don't know how to say it, or your God, they do some certain things where you don't like. You know, if you pour them out, you know, if you confront her, you know, if you tell her and say, ah, you know, do. You don't do. Or family, your husband family will be doing some certain things. You say, my God, you just keep quiet because you don't want people to know. You don't want to say it out. No, sometimes you need to. That's why I don't pray for 100 plus one marriage. No, all I pray to God in my marriage is for long life and grace of God to handle my family. And that is what you'll be praying for. But that kind of a marriage, that problem that will escalate, that my God, the whole world we know will come out to social media like this and all those kind of stuff. This is not what we are asking God for. If problem did not come because of children, problem may come because of maybe the man is not giving too much, you know, time for the family. That is what I'm talking about. That kind of a thing, it happens every day. It happens every day. So, but what we ask God is the ability, you know, to tackle it, the ability to sort things out, and things continue to go on again. So for this, you know, side of this woman, she said, none of such, they have never quarreled for once. Nothing. And she didn't even get only one picking for the man. You got other children. If you hear for the background, when it's all my guests, where my guests, Oyamekuna come, she carry her grown-up children, come for the wedding. You know, with the little baby, the last one where she still, Omomo, where she carry for hand, where she still back, where she carry come. Me, they ask myself now, for this kind of a person, this kind of man, waiting this man will say now that this woman not a given. Let's be frank here. Let's be sincere. What will he say now that this is the problem? Is it that the woman did not give birth to children? Is it that the woman is not good in bed? Is it that the woman is barren? I don't know. I don't get it. This is the place that always confused me sometimes when I see that a woman, we the women, we give a lot. If you will believe me, we give a lot from relationship to marriage. We are the sacrificial lamb here. They will come, the man will buy you. Because I say that in one of my videos that they sell us. They are our parents, they sell us. And when they say you to a man, the man, after all, he has given heaven and earth. Daddy, the daddy that nobody never paid before. I pay your daddy, now you are mine. And this is the word that I hate when some men say it. You know, now you are mine. So they can use you anyhow. They can do anyhow they like on you. They can beat you. And some parents, when their son-in-law will be treating their daughter so bad, you will cry, come meet the same parents. They will push you back. May you go. Because they believe, say, they don't collect money. They believe, say, they no fee pay their bride price back. They believe, say, my God, the man now is the owner of you. Total package. You know, he don't buy you. So nobody have any right to say anything. And this, which is very, very wrong. For Igbo land, where I came from, now we all this kind of a thing, they happen well. When you don't pay bride price, marry a woman, my God, oh, you come like say the family, they don't remove hand, remove leg. Some they go say, huh, anything. If you they complain from money tonight, they will tell you now your husband may you the bearer, which is very bad. See the case of this woman now. Tell me waiting this man go say, now be waiting with this woman do. Now picking where God no give them. Maybe I don't know, I'm not there. Maybe the woman have not given birth to a male child, but this is not the reason that the man should do such an evil act. I didn't see this as a normal thing. It's evil when you marry a woman, because all what I consider in a marriage, when a man is paid your bride price, if a man have not paid your bride price, you are not married. If you are watching me here, I am not trying to provoke you. I am not trying to insult you. if you're a married woman, don't call a man that is not the man that have not paid your bride price your husband. It's not done. Okay? God did not recognize such a marriage. Even the church, nobody. And we are fond of that, to call such a man my baby father or my friend. Even in Dutch, in this Germany or any part of Europe we are living. Here that I'm living in Germany, they don't recognize such. They don't. If you're married, there is a paper that shows that both of you are married. They cannot call. Maybe both of you are feloped. This, both of you are whatever. That one is acceptable. Boyfriend and girlfriend coming together, having children. Yes, they know that. But in times of marriage, they will know that you are married. And for me, when a man pay your bride price. But this woman now, she's boldly saying it outside, inside the church, that they are married. And God has blessed them with children, not one, not twice, maybe three or more. Tell me. Even he said the man slept with her. You know, that's the man do some, you know, cleaning, washing of plates, you know, clearing and, you know, forwarding. The man did all of those things. Gave her kiss this morning and rushed to the bathroom, bath, clean up, you know, barb his beard, put on his best eyeglasses, put on some fine perfumes. Zoom of this morning. Thinking maybe he went to work, thinking maybe he went for an important appointment, not knowing that the man is on the altar with black suit, white, that's black suit with tie and, you know, those kind of stuff, to go and tell a woman, yes, I do. Hey, Jesus of Nazareth, what a wicked heart. What a wicked heart, you know? Why? How did you define this, my people? As you, they watch me now, how do you see it? Is it good? What kind of, you know, in a category of sin, in a category of evil, where will you qualify this now? Where will you put this? It's so heartbroken. It's so evil. So bad. Look at the way she's shouting. Sometimes, you know, I do also ask question that the Reverend Father, I know that the man, there will be no blame on him, because maybe he has no contact to these people. He has no contact to the woman. He don't know that the man has been married before. I believe as this woman walked in there, as they used to ask, is there anybody that knows what can stop this marriage? Which they always ask. Say or hold your peace. That's when this woman just came in, said, no, Reverend Father, stop the marriage. It will not hold. She was trying to figure out what went wrong. What have I done? Where have I failed you that you can do such an evil thing to me? See, life is not that way. I know many of our women are passing through such. Many, even there are some of our brothers, they have a wife at home. They are still here married to a white woman. They are still here married to a black woman. Why? What do you gain from such? What do you gain from such a life? If you don't need a woman, if you don't want a man, divorce is possible. If you both did not marry in a law court, you marry a traditional way, go to the family, give a drink, tell them that what you saw before is not what you are seeing now. You call it a quit, call it over. Then you go your way, I'll go my way. They know they keep us in put. And they talk and say marriage is not a do or die affair. And no fee die. You know, all this one with my husband, all this pretense. If that man tomorrow, they find the man, say, no day, I never see any woman. Maybe say, even as you, they cry, we are black or we are white from mortuary. Oh, they go carry the man. Oh, my husband, everybody, they cry, they shout. See grave. That minute, maybe say, they want to put the man inside that grave. I never see any woman upon that cry where you they cry for months, say, make you enter inside the grave, follow the man. No one have ever done that. No, have you seen anyone? No. No one has done it. And no man has also, no man have ever done that. Say, this woman I marry so much. This bride price that, my God, that I don't want anybody to take from me. This bride price I paid. So am I going to leave this bride price to just go? No man has ever followed his wife or her wife to the grave. Nobody have done that. So what are we now talking about? That is some certain things that, you know, I say marriage in Australia, they carry on. And always they talk. I not tell you, say, may you hate your husband. I not tell you, say, may you not love your husband. I love my own with all my heart, all my soul and spirit. Now here, if you don't depend you, I talk to some of my fellow women, will be say, your marriage, na cat and rat, na beating up and down. My man go, they beat you, they disgrace you, they do all kind of a thing. You just, they bear them. Ah, may they not come to say, I leave my marriage. May they not come laugh at me. When they go laugh at you, and when you enter grave, even as you do them, they much worry. You know, some side chick don't dead there. They console your husband. They console him. Immediately, they want, they put you to rest to that grave. Just give the man 2 months. That if it will reach self, you don't see, you don't, they go corner, corner. Some they go and they say, ah, Ogana, these children, not go leave them alone. I need someone to, before he knows it, later 6 months, piam, the man don't marry. All those lovey-lovey, all those promises, all those, you not go there again. Another person don't take your place. And may God never be, may that never be your portion. It will never be your portion. So this is it. Every woman, you marry, my God, you never have, you don't have, you never, God have not blessed you with children. Everybody will be crying, oh my God, why my own? 4 years has gone, 3 years has gone, 6 years, 5 years. See, after you give birth to the same children, after you suffer, after laboring and everything from relationship, they will be banking you from when you get to the marriage, in pregnancy time, when you put to bed, no rest. They will be banking you front to back, corner, every time, morning, night, and day. At the end, this is the result. So this man now, what will he say that is what is lacking? Are you lacking a wife? The woman is, he has a good figure. It's not yelekute. So it's not that you start banking her this morning, doing all sorts of that. Then you want to go to marry another woman. You are on the altar. Maybe you have already paid bride price. Do all sorts of, you know, traditional things they need to do in a woman. All those things have been going on all this while. Because you can't just wake up in the morning, you see a girl today, you go and buy suit, buy wedding gown, you want to marry her. Relationships have been going on. He proposed the girl, he went to the family, visit them, do all sorts of, and this woman was not even aware of it. Or, if not that fateful day, what a wicked man. What a wicked heart. My fellow women, I am not talking to you for you to disrespect your husband, to hate your marriage, or try to do some funny things that will make your husband to beat you or to leave you. No. But sometimes there are some certain things, my God, when you see it going on, try to be wise. Try to be watchful in your marriage, in anything you do. See how many months now this thing has been going on. This man, they didn't start 1 week or 2 weeks. To the extent of the day, that is the how God wants to expose him. Maybe somebody gave her the information that see what is going on, and she came at the right time. So what do you think? What do you need? What do you say? What do you have to say? What do you think for your mind? Say, ah, this man is doing well. He not doing well. For my own eye as a human being, he not doing well. If at all, even though say this woman never born for her, he not fit treat her like that. It's something I go sit down together, say, ah, wait till I see before, not be wait till I do it, wait till I see again. You see they intact, nothing don't come off for your body, choose, chow, everybody go waka. Not be say when the woman don't born, you don't do everything, they serve you, they treat you, they cook. Now we, they suffer in a marriage pass. Whether your marriage is 100% plus or not, now we, they suffer pass. From relationship, from when you marry, they bring you home. Now so would they lick men up and down, they walk up and down. Now so would they serve them like tomorrow, no day. It's good to worship your husband, to serve him, because he's your Lord. That is how it's God made it. Abraham was a Lord to Sarah. So our husband, they are our Lord. But some of them that doesn't appreciate all of this is the ones that pissed me off sometimes when I see them after a woman has given all of this. When you remember when you were single, you were not like this. Before you get into marriage, sex, morning, night, and day, and every time, and going, you give birth. See wrinkles. See that your slim stomach will not expand like never before. Those figures will not be there again. It will not be there. So in all of this, what do you tell the woman? Thank you. Showing her appreciation. Showing her love. The only thing you will see, but maybe there is another one. That one will also expire. That same side chick will also expire one day. Of course. Of course. Nobody vomits. Pregnancy, they don't they carry them from out. Now here I go enter. Now there I go, they develop. That same belly, where you see, say, ah, this belly in a flat one, you go soon, you know, open. Everybody go see him. You go born. So, my wonderful people, sorry for that noise. This is all I have for you this morning. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Share this video. And may God Almighty help us to keep our marriage. Our marriage never have comma. We will live long in our marriage. We will train our children. Our husband will continue to love us. Another woman will never take your place. Another woman will not take your place. So what you suffered, you will live long to enjoy the fruit of your labor. God bless you this morning. Thank you so much. Share, invite your friends. Please like this video, comment, and also subscribe. Love you. See you in my next video. I remember your God.